Today's Captain's Blog. In today's episode, I'm actually getting to build something. I may be a little project deprived, working on lab things all the time. But one of our awesome staff members scrounged this out of a trash pile somewhere, and it is a slab of IKEA from the look of it. So we're going to pick that for the top because it's the cleaner, nicer side. And we're going to set it bottom side top-wise on a nice rubber mat we have here and do some layout. We're going to turn this and those two sticks of conduit into a coffee table in mere moments. So, this is going to be neat. First, I got to get a couple things. I'll be back. Alright, so we got to do a little layout. Hey, Bruce!
Yes, sir?
I need that drywall square. This ain't got enough length. I only need it for like 30 seconds, but I need it pretty bad. Story of my life, man. Thank you, son.
You're welcome.
You got a protractor anywhere? I sent Harris for one 10 minutes ago, and
we've got one that's kind of funky and not quite right, but it might be a bit
That's roughly what we're headed for. Yeah, that's close enough. Okay. So now we gotta do is bend conduit at that angle twice. Or close. It doesn't have to be exact. So, we'll mark out our conduit for the middle. These are 10 foot lengths of conduit. We'll mark them out at 5. Square up our ends. So that's where we want our apex of our bend.
Put a square mark instead?
No. Square only gives me a 90 degree angle. What if I need a 25 degree angle? Huh? Did I ask for a protractor?
Yeah, I
couldn't find it. Is it safe to assume if you need a protractor, you might be making angles?
Yeah.
Okay. Hey, you know where you should check? Art department.
Here's one right there.
What? That's a left-handed protractor. Okay, so
what are you talking about?
Give me that before you move it. Thank you.
Alright,
so 115 degrees is about what we need. This doesn't go that way. This only goes up.
The camera.
Well, what you're thinking. Harris, I got a problem.
What?
A conduit bender bends in 90 degree angles. I can bend 10, 22, 30, 45, 60, anything between 0 and 90 really, but you can't go more than 90.
You need to do 90 and then 15.
I don't need to go more than 90. I need to go less than 90. That's bigger than 90. It's less than 90. It's bigger than 90.
Can't you do
more than 90 less than
90? Can't you do that angle?
I need.
No, you want to do this angle.
I want that angle.
Okay.
That's 90. That's more than 90. That's 180. That's more than 90. That's 90 to 0.
You bent it 180.
Look, that's 90. There, I bent it 180.
Yeah, exactly.
That's 90. Plus 10 is 100, plus 20 is 110, 115.
That should go.
But that doesn't make sense because I didn't read them right on. I'm just going to bend the thing by eye and kink it until it looks right. How about that?
Okay.
There's a way to do this with math.
Is that a hammer?
Huh? Is this a hammer? No. Have you never seen one of these before?
No, it isn't.
Well, this is magic. Watch this. You hook it on a pipe like that, okay? That's our middle spot, which is, we're going to cut the ends off anyway, so it doesn't have to be exact.
Okay.
But that's our middle spot, okay? You see how this has cleats on it? Watch this, I'm going to show you magic. See that nice straight piece of pipe? You put your foot there. You lean back on it a bit. Now, come here.
Yeah?
You're going to do serious important job, okay? Put that on the floor. Now, don't touch it. When this, just hold it there.
One more.
And, yeah, that's. Oh, it's almost perfect. All right. You happy with that?
Does that make you feel good?
Does that make you feel like a man?
I don't know, you want it perfect, sure.
All right, well, let's see how we fit there. We can always bend it more. We can even straighten it out a little bit if we have to. Now let's see how it looks here. Oh, look at that. Look at that, Harris. Look at that! Spitting on things. Look at that! Isn't that great?
Yeah.
Isn't that the most beautiful thing you've ever seen in your life?
Sure.
It totally is. All right, so we've done it once. Now we have to do it again. All right? Let's grab the other piece. We have our mark. Our mark. I'm just going to put this arbitrarily near where we're headed. Okay. Ready? Let's do it again. One more.
That's good. Yeah.
That looks more better. Too much. It's okay, I can take it out if we have to. Yeah, let's check this out. That's a little bit too much.
Yeah.
Just a hair.
Yeah.
Cool thing about conduit is it's funky. Oh, it's lovely. That's almost perfect.
The question is, which one's better?
That one's a little bit better. It's always best your first time. Never quite the same. Alright, so we've got this. Now, here's our first step. Okay? On our path to glory and greatness. And that will be totally cool. Okay? We might even bring them in a little bit. Because they could totally touch. They could totally touch, Harris.
Sure.
But they don't have to. We have to leave room for Jesus.
I do.
I'll leave room for Jesus. All right. So, there.
Oh, I think.
Let me see that big blue thing.
I think I got it.
Do you?
I
Don't tell anybody else. That's our stub out. It's 6 inches to stub for 3/4. Okay. So,
you're going to go down to the corner.
Yeah, but we're going to stub 6. Okay. Well, when this makes a bend,
okay,
if you put this on the pipe right there, and if you look at the bend, the distance from the edge here to the straight part here, you use up 6 inches of space. Okay?
Okay.
So if we know we want the legs to come down about here, what we do is we start right at the corner of the table and we come in 6 inches. Okay, so if I put a mark here and we bend right off that arrow, this pipe is gonna go is gonna have to start bending here to come down straight here. Okay? So what we're gonna do, just to make it nice and clean and safe, is from the corner of the table, we're gonna come back 8 inches, and that'll give us a couple inches of wiggle room out here, okay? So we're gonna come back from the very corner of the table, or come back 8 inches, like that. Then we go over here, the very corner of the table.
When you did it before, though, the legs aren't quite all the same length.
Well, we're gonna bend them up, and then we have the legs going down, right? Then we cut them off. We measure off the table to where we want the leg to be, and then we just cut the pipe, and there'll be a little, we'll have a couple scrap pieces.
Oh.
But conduit's really, really cheap, so, and we'll use the stub pieces somewhere else in the project somewhere. So, yeah.
Okay.
So all we gotta do is put a bend. Now we make a mark. We've got our mark here for where we want our bend to be, right? Now on this side of the mark, we're gonna put a little bend, okay? That means that we want our bend to be on this side of the lung, because it's easy to get confused.
Yeah.
We make our mark, and we put our bend, and we're going to make a note.
How do you attach this to this?
We'll get to that.
We're not at that step yet.
First, we have to make these pieces of pipe. But we'll get there.
You will drill a hole and zip tie it?
No, we are not going to just drill a hole and zip tie. Oh my God. Now, this tells us our bend's on this side. So the trick is, that little arrow has to line up on our mark. Get that shuffled down. Right on there. Now we've got our little arrow on our mark. Right? So we take this and we go. We just put in a nice 90 degree bend. This is really hard to do with both talk and balance and stuff. Right? It's a little bit more than 90. Okay, so there's about a 90 degree bend. We go over here. Now do you start to see the shape? See, it works. Now we know our bend's on this side of this line. So you get a lot going on. It's easy to get lost. That's why I was taught to make a mark on which side's going to be your bend.
Yeah, I can see how easy it would be to put it on my
bend. Yeah, it's really easy to screw it up. We have legs! Isn't it great? It's great! We have legs. Okay? Isn't that lovely? And then we'll measure down how far we want them to be. We'll just cut them off. Because if they want a table that's 4 foot high, we're set.
Hang on.
What?
That one is not terrible.
They will be when we're done. It's all, you can tweak it all around. This is not a table that you rebuild engines on. There's our first one. So we come over here and we do what we did on that side because it worked great over there. So we do the same thing again. Make sure.
There's another thing I notice one of the legs is further in out.
Do you have freckles?
I don't think so.
You want to?
Okay,
there. Okay. Hold that right there, and just one finger. No, right here. Okay. Just put a finger. No, you can't slide it around. It all goes.
Here, move your hand.
Can't slide it around, man. You'll give us peace without honor. All right, so how far do we go in from the very corner?
8.
Very good. So measure an 8 from the very corner. Put a mark there. Where do we want the bend?
On the far
inside or the outside?
Outside.
So we'll put the bend here. If this is wrong, they're all going to know you did it.
Yep.
Okay. You're calling the shots. And measure an 8 from the corner.
Mm-hmm.
There. Okay. Yeah, we got our marks, we got our pipe, we know everything goes. Let's do this. This, by the way, is what happens if you hire an electrician to do carpentry, just so you know. If you've got a hammer, everything looks like a nail.
That looks like a nail.
These work as a hammer too, but you gotta be really upset. So this with 3/4 is kinda hard. It's not too bad. And if you're a big, rugged, burly guy, it's pretty easy.
How do you get different sizes of hammers?
You buy different kinds of fenders. Though this one will do half inch if you need it. This will do half inch okay. But it really wants 3/4. And they make these. They go up to like inch, which is hard, and I think inch and a quarter, inch and a half, an inch and a quarter, inch, one of those, it's inch and a quarter, inch and a half. The thing is so big, the lever's like this tall, and the foot thing has a kick out bit, so you can get like both feet on there, and then you have another guy standing on it. Yeah, it's a job. They don't sell tools like that to me. If I walk into the electrical supply place and try and buy an inch and a half conduit bender, they just giggle and say, no, kid. That's too much fluid. Because I don't have enough lead in my butt to move it. I do. Very small amount.
Yeah.
Anybody born before 1983 has a small amount of lead in their butt. See how I bent it too far?
Yeah.
I push here, bend it back a little bit. So I bent it just a little bit too far. And if you really need to tweak it, you stand on it like that. Put this, see how the hand's got a little bell? So you can put that in there. Like that. Tweak it where you need it. Which is why we don't have to be exact. Because that thing will tweak it for us. Now we put this on here, and it fits. Grab the other. Put that on there, and it fits. Look at that. Now it's starting to look like something, huh? Yeah. All right, so now it's going to be a little tippy. There, how's that? Looks like a table already.
That's going to be awesome.
It'll be fixed. We're not there yet. Our next step is we have to find the right screws. Now this table is about a half inch. Grab tape measure. Yeah, it's half inch thick. All right, grab one of those metal things in the box.
Oh, that's right.
That's how we're going to do it. So these are like 16.
You're going to want one of those right on either side of the bend in the middle.
All we're going to go find the right bolt.
Come with me.
Quarter 20
would be just
a,
yeah, quarter 20 would be great.
So these are half.
Half inch
is the smallest we got. Yeah, I don't want the smallest we got. I want probably these.
Top table is the
second. Might need 1 inch.
What you want, man?
I think I want quarter 21 with nuts and washers. I'm gonna go check to be sure. Give me a nut for quarter 20.
You want something, because then you can countersink it through the wood and make it nice and flush on top, yeah. Instead of going...
You got nuts and washers to fit. I only got a half inch board. I don't know that I could go and countersink them that deep.
Oh, yeah.
I only got a half inch board.
Well, like, yeah.
Can you give me a nice pan head screw?
If you go I got
pan head, yeah. You have a nice 420 pan head?
Yeah.
You just need like three quarter inch or something like that.
Give me some 1 inch and I'll see which works better. Give me a 3/4, give me a 1. Give me a nut and a washer and I'll try them out.
So I'm gonna put these in the wrong row.
Put those back where they belong. That's a 3/4 and a 1.
That's that 1? That's a 1.
Alright. Here, I'll give you this. Give me a nut and a washer. I'm gonna need 8 of whatever I use.
8?
Yep, we're gonna need 8.
You want regular nuts or you want nylons?
Nah, just regular nuts is fine.
6, 7, 8.
Are you just gonna have to end that bolt stick through the table?
Alright. You got a drill bit for quarter 20?
Like, you know, quarter inch drill bit?
Yeah. Okay, hook it up.
Wow. Go get one of those that isn't as sharp as the end of your dick. Look at that. That, wow.
That's a good time right there.
You can poke somebody in the eye with that and not hurt them.
What did you want, 3/4 or 1 inch?
I'll let you know in a second. I gotta do an experiment here.
You want?
I want 1 inch. I'll take 7 more, please, sir. All right, see, when we need to figure out which size we wanted. We got a half inch thing here. Now if I use that, I barely make it through, even though this is a 3/4 inch bolt. But if I go with a 1 inch, which is the next size up, I got that much sticking through. And you got to remember, I need to go through the thing, and then through the mount. So now I'm out to there. And then I got to put on a washer. So now I'm out to there, and I gotta have room enough for a nut. So that's just about perfect. I got like 2 threads hanging out. That's it.
So that's lovely. That's right where we want to be.
Thank you, sir. Harris is coming with the drill. All right. I'm gonna mount this. So now all we gotta do is figure out where we wanna put our bolts. That's pretty easy. We'll just take one of these, which will be our nice marker. They don't have to be exact, but we want them to be reasonably close. Thank you, sir.
Yeah.
Get me a little rubber mallet, please. Okay, so those will end up about there. We'll put these on the inside, way down here at our lines, because because those will all match up. And we know that that's as far out as we can put them. And we could probably get away with significantly less than four of these per leg, but that's what I'm going with because there's no engineering like over-engineering. We could probably easily get away with just one here, one there, and one in the middle, and the two in the middle could probably share a bolt. And I might actually do that and use that as how we offset them. I could put one like that, and that would push them down just a hair. And then I could put the other one on the same thing, on the same bolt like that, and that would give us our offset. That could actually be a pretty good idea. That could look neat. So if I were to put that like that, right at the apex, that could be cool. That could actually, and it lines up decent. Yeah, I'm doing that. I'm doing that. That's a good idea. Okay, so we'll just drill a hole right at the cross. We'll lay this down. Yep, our bolt fits it just beautifully.
Hey, Harris.
Yeah?
Hey, Batman.
What?
Here, man.
I know you're going to have that issue.
What?
You're going to drill the whole table.
Yeah, you want to drill through the whole table. This way we don't have to mess with countersinking or... Hey, can you grab me one of these that's an inch and a quarter, please?
I can get
it. I think I only go up to an inch and a half.
All right, give me an inch and a half. Just neck size bigger.
Just need one?
Just need one. I gotta do some stacking. Hey, Harris.
Yeah?
Find us a big Phillips head screwdriver.
How big?
Number two at least, number three would be even better.
Hey, what about that giant one?
No. Number two or number three?
How big is that? Four?
Yeah, but you don't do it with the style that I do. You gotta want it. Alright, so we're gonna put that big long bolt in the middle. That'll stay there on its own. So, we grab this. Right. Set it about there. You grab one of these.
Back it over.
I don't know if it's going to work. Just stay tuned and you'll see. That's part of the adventure of this great mystery of life, Harris. We don't know. It's all an experiment. There's no sure answers. We don't know until we just try it, do it, see. Find me another one of those washers, sir.
Beef?
Yep.
Good night, all.
And another nut. Good night, Mr. Minkus, sir. We'll be here to love you.
Quarter 20 size.
No, I need a half 13. Yes, I need a quarter 20. All right, so this is cool because this holds everything nice and straight while we do all the other bits. Yeah. That just keeps everything in position. Now we can line these up, get them all right where we want them. These are never going to be perfectly matched. I could spend 20 minutes doing the layout and getting them all exactly right, but I'm just not that motivated. And the owner of this table doesn't really care all that much. Those will all match.
Here you go.
Thank you, sir.
Used an extra one.
Two extra.
That's pretty close. That one's dead on. There.
That's just about where we want everything.
Harris, give me a tiny little drill bit.
Okay.
Like an eighth inch. Maybe even smaller.
Okay, now we gotta be really sure we got everything where we want it. Because once we do this, we're locked in.
I gotta drill from the back through the front. And if you do that full size, you'll tear out the wood a little bit. So you do it with little tiny holes, and then you don't tear the wood up. And now that we've got all our pilot holes drilled, we can take this apart.
Clear out. Hey Batman?
Yeah.
Can I have a socket that fits a quarter 20?
Yeah. Harris, do you know what size socket is for
2, but we don't care because that's the bottom of the table.
Couldn't you just flip it over and call the top the bottom?
That would be deceitful. That would lead us into a life of sin and hedonism, which I'm all for, but you can't handle that at your age.
Oh.
You can't have a life of sin and hedonism until you're at least a sophomore. Okay.
We're gonna take all our screws.
Screw an inch hole.
If you've got the stones, man, take it. Alright, now we're there. Look at that.
little short. There. It's quite lovely. Do you feel how lovely it is?
Or is it just a laptop desk?
It's just like a little coffee table.
Oh, alright.
Yeah, this is great.
This is actually better built than a lot of chairs I've owned. See, if your hole doesn't quite line up... Oh, hold that. Bring it up easy. If your hole doesn't quite line up, you just move the little mount thing a little bit. And you're fine. Now, put a washer on each one. Now, make sure to put the washers right side out. Hang on. Look at the washer. See how one side's round, one side's sharp?
Yeah,
sharp side goes down. Okay, and then we put a nut on each one.
The nuts are bidirectional.
Don't tighten the nuts. The nuts are bidirectional, yes. Not all nuts are, but these nuts are. Don't tighten the nuts down tight yet, because we still got to...
Finger tighter now.
Yeah, finger tight. Your finger tight. Not a Minkus finger tight. Nuts on one at a time as everything comes into alignment.
That's not very aligned.
It will. Don't move it! I'm putting this nut on. Let go. Let go.
Sorry.
See, you put that on, you get that one aligned, then you come over here and mess with this. The easiest way is to pop it off, set this down, line that up, and then it's on. Washer and nut, please. Thank you. Done. Okay, now we need one more of these. It goes right there, and a nut.
I did bring you another egg.
Okay, here's a nut.
Thank you.
Now, it's assembled, at least.
So what do I do with this one?
That one?
Say ah.
No. I'm going to show you where it goes.
You're good.
It'll fit.
I'd rather not.
It'll fit.
It's going to be a Stop the Harris Abuse page soon.
Never happened.
I don't think anyone cares enough.
Jesus.
Now the trick with these is to not over-tighten them. Just enough to make a pucker in the wood. That's okay. Over and look at the top. See, there's just these little nubs. That's it. Okay.
Are you gonna like sand them down or something?
No, we're not sanding them down. Alright. Now, I was told they wanted this 18 inches up. So we take this, we lay this flat on the table.
Don't you want to go 18 and a half?
They wanted it 18 inches high.
Yeah, but you want to cut yourself a little bit of slack, don't you? case you mess up or something.
There is no margin for error. This is a coffee table for, like, NASA. It has to be exactly perfect. If they want the table 18 inches high, we cut the legs 17 and a half off the bottom because the bottom's a half inch thick. So we go on the right scale, 17 and a half. We make our mark. Go tell Batman you need the good conduit cutter.
Okay.
This on. You got two rollers in here and one roller out here, and this roller is hardened and sharpened. You line this up to where you're cutting, you ratchet that down, you give it just a little bit of tension, you drive all the way around, and you make sure you hit your line where you started. And you give it another little bit of tension, go all the way around, just like that. Science happening there, yeah. All the way around just like that. And that just pops right off. And that piece is scrap. Come over here and you do it again.
Wouldn't it be easier to straighten them when they're longer though?
Yes.
So why aren't we doing that?
Didn't really care that much.
Oh.
That would have been the better way, because if we straightened them perfectly when they were longer, then when we cut them off, they'll all be exactly. These are going to be off by a little tiny bit, each one, but there's a really easy way to fix that.
Mallet?
There's going to be feet put on the end of these. So you, if any one of them's short and it wobbles a little bit, you put a washer in the cup of the foot before you slip it on. It takes the wiggle out of it. And if you really want to cheat and guarantee that your coffee table has no wiggle at all, only make one with three legs.
But if you only use two?
If you use two, it won't stand up.
I have two legs.
And I've seen the difficulty you have in maintaining upright. Stand up straight.
Your leg.
Hey, you want to mock me. You want to sit there with a mouthful of smartass. I totally have the ability to use your powers against you.
Yes, you
That's
do.
Fair game.
Yes, you do.
Now, we don't have the feet for this, so we can't do the final step in the leveling. But, at this point, it's far enough along that the person for whom we are building this coffee table is capable of finishing it out on their own, and everything's cool.
Where are we building this for?
Huh?
Who is this for?
Oh, it's for a secret client.
Judging by how little you seem to care about how this
is, a bespoke high-end custom piece of beautiful furniture. Ta-da! Coffee table. Just like that.
Cool.
Out of nothing but two pieces of conduits and fasteners and an old junk bit of IKEA out of the trash. Now you, sir, please put the tools away.
Here. We just finished doing the exact opposite. We have, we have an IKEA bottom and we made our own top.
That's sexy. So you got a hexagon table. This is one of the new lobby tables?
Yeah.
Quick question.
Yeah? What is it?
Hey! We should make a new table exactly every day. One table a day.
Now that we got it figured out, should
Moose wants this done.
They have to be done at exactly the same interval. You can't make like one today and four tomorrow. It's got to be one a day, every day.
That won't reach the deadline.
Then they're periodic. Periodic.
That's one of the jokes. If he had said it, would get him with the 5 gallon buckets running around the building.
Yeah,
lucky are you.
All right, so that's the project du jour. Their table, which they worked on, when did you start on this? Like first thing, pretty much. This has been your whole
kind
day.
Of,
yeah.
Well, we did grand left and right for
okay, so this is your all day table. That's my like half hour table.
I like crooked.
Legs aren't crooked. They're supposed to be bent. That's a custom feature.
Uh-huh.
Hey, that's not bad for two pieces of conduit and a junk IKEA slab. They still got the conduit stickers on them.
Yeah, that's high class. Right?
That's. Now, if you're really high class, you make feet for it out of Gazinta fittings.
Hey, we need some conduit, and you're going on the floor.
Okay. Now what we do, we take these, we put them in the middle, coming out. No, just one in the middle coming out into an octagon box with some armored conduit, armored flux conduit.
Yes. Okay.
To light bulb fittings and have a dedicated lamp built into the table. You got some. All right, time is 21:24 hours, and I want to take a minute, and look at that, that's me on the live stream. We're on the live stream right now. But I want to take a minute and thank Dax Bourbon. I've been saying that Dax Breven forever. It's Dax Bourbon. I want to thank Peter W., Adam Wamsley, and Paul Plusa, who are all my newest guys on Patreon. Thank you for helping out and being part of the solution. That's really cool. So, that's the blog for today, building a table. You guys have fun. We'll be back tomorrow, and thank you for helping out on Patreon. If you're interested in helping support the blog, go on Patreon. The link is below here in the description, and I would dearly love your help with this. Thank you, guys. See you.